my friends, and welcome to this ASMR video in which I will be looking through a 90s football magazine. This one here I have in front of me, Match Magazine from Saturday, August the 20th, 1994. I possibly would have got this one at the time. I would have been 9 years old. 70p it cost, probably about, this is probably about the time I would have been starting to get into these sort of magazines. As you can see, this one is actually sealed. I bought this from a retro football memorabilia shop near me. And this is bringing back lots of memories for me, lots of nostalgia. I have more of these magazines to look through. I bought a few of them, but I'll do one per video because otherwise the videos will go on for too long. Plus, I'm not sure how it's going to go. So, without further ado, let's have a look at this magazine from 1994. We are 29 years on from this magazine. Wow, that's incredible. Okay. No free gifts to talk of on this one, particularly apart from some posters. Before I continue, actually, one thing I did want to point out, what I noticed before, we have the price in pence, and there are also some other prices on this front cover, and one of them is US, and I'm not sure how well this will appear on the screen. But it says on there, US $3.50, which by my maths tells me, means that the pound was worth five times the dollar at the time. Now I may have got this wrong, my world knowledge isn't incredible, so maybe it refers to something else, but for a layman like me that looks like dollars are worth a fifth of a pound, which, considering I went to America only a few months ago and it was about $0.83 to the pound, it's a hell of a difference. Anyway, let's get started with the video. Jones or Phil Charnock, Rob Jones, Ronnie Moran, Steve Harkness, Steve Nicol, Nigel Clough, Paul Stewart. Oh, that's Lee Jones. Sticking Gibbionaby, Michael Thomas, Doug Livermore, Sammy Lee, Julian Dix, Neil Ruddock, Robbie Fowler, Ian Rush, Roy Evans, John Barnes, Jamie Redknapp, Don Hutchinson and Steve McManaman. This is by no means a classic Liverpool team. I don't think they did particularly well this season. Robbie Fowler was one of my heroes growing up. Also like John Barnes and Steve McManaman. Who was that player? He was the one, I wasn't sure. Yeah, Phil Charnock. Okay. Let's move the poster out of the way and we can look at the magazine itself. Klinsmann, Kanchelskis and Schwartz. Now, this was the season that Klinsmann joined Tottenham, I think, after the World Cup 94. Okay. I hope nostalgia doesn't play tricks on me, and I hope this is actually a good read, but I'm not looking, I don't think I've got high expectations for it. I don't really have a 9-year-old's mind right anymore, so. The first section is called Route 1. I'm going to move the magazine this side so there's no glare from the light. So, we have lists of famous football fans. Paul Daniels is a Doncaster fan, apparently. It's definitely clear that this was made for kids. John Barnes in it. That was one of my first football kits, that one, that gold one. Ultimate Challenge, I did like that bit, I'll look forward to that later on. So, a bit of random stuff at the start of the magazine. We're into it. Interview here with Chris Armstrong, who at the time was playing for Crystal Palace, 23 years old. He ended up playing for Tottenham Hotspur. I used to enjoy reading these interviews, actually. I loved magazines as a kid. I used to read them from cover to cover. Used to be really excited. Really excited to read them and get new issues. This is funny. We couldn't really have had a much harder test than opening him against Liverpool, but I can't wait. I have some bad news for you, Chris. That one ended 6-1 to Liverpool. Okay, this page is of random football images. And a few quips, captions with them. A few famous faces here. That one's probably from the same photo shoot as the poster that I got out of this issue. One thing that won't become clear, obviously, on the video, but I can really sense, is the smell of the magazine. It smells old. We have an advert for Umbro boots. Umbro not quite so popular now as they were in the 90s. A poster of Nicky Summerby of Manchester City. I do remember that advert. Reebok were very popular in the mid to late 90s with Ryan Giggs and a couple of other faces that had them. I did like Reebok. They sponsored Liverpool as well. Or rather, they were the kit manufacturer for Liverpool. Obviously, this is peak Ryan Giggs. And speaking of the devil, here he is. So, who is going to win this season's Premiership title race? We asked some of your favourite stars to elect their choice for the year's main title contenders. So, let's see who they predict. So, Newcastle player predicts Newcastle. Liverpool predicts Arsenal. Manchester. Interestingly, Blackburn player chooses Manchester United. It ended up being Blackburn. Hans Sagers is correct. Ryan Giggs obviously chooses Manchester United. Manchester United, Manchester United, Manchester United, Manchester United. Sean Teal randomly goes for Leeds. I don't know where they finished this season, but they weren't near the top. And this is the odds. Man United did start the season favourites. With new signings such as David May and Graham Tomlinson bolstering this. I don't think Graham Tomlinson did much bolstering. Of course, Sutton really helped Blackburn. Yeah. season, he ended up joining Manchester United from Newcastle, and his misses in the last day actually cost them the title, or was partly why they didn't win that game. And Liverpool, Gavin Peacock there in a, I used to wear classic a lot, but it's in my mind that's a classic, as in memorable kit. You don't even see many like that. In fact, you almost can't see him. It's one of those ones like Manchester United's one that they swapped at half time against Southampton. Sports Use Unlimited. Well, I don't think they're around anymore. But if we look at the prices of trainers, you know, you're looking at £50, £30, £40. With inflation, actually, trainers haven't gone up that much, I don't think. But then I don't know if that's the best quality trainers around at the time. There you go, order it online, send off. About Alan Ball, Southampton manager at the time, profile about John Hawkes, top music, I really like you too. I just bought the new Seal CD, which quite impressed me. Massimo Mauro, I can't say I remember that man. More adverts for sportswear. Eric Cantona t-shirt there. Mark Hughes modelling it, lovely. Not sure who that is. Andre Kanchuska's poster there. Stefan Schwartz, Jurgen Klinsmann, and the Manchester City team there. I did just like Paul Walsh. Now this bit in the middle I really used to like because it had all of the results. And back before the days of the internet, teams and the results in here was actually really, really important to me on a Tuesday when this magazine came out. Obviously these days it wouldn't work because of the internet, but also it wouldn't work because the games aren't just Saturday anymore. You've got Sunday, you've got Monday, in fact every day of the week. I might be wrong, this might be a false memory, but I seem to think that on Match Facts they only went up to the Saturday games, so Sunday games aren't on here, which gives it a bit of a false feeling by the time you read this on a Tuesday. So this is just having, looks like some rumours and news about teams, random teams including foreign teams. So for Liverpool, Robbie Fowler scored a hat-trick in Liverpool. 3-0 win over Hertha Berlin in Germany. Frank McAvenny given a free by Celtic. Frank McAvenny, he seems like an old man to me. Wow, I can't believe that he's still playing at this point. Craig Levein, of course, went on to manage them. We have a little cartoon there. In the same game, Darren Anderton was carried off. That's not a surprise. notes after seeing if I made a mistake in signing for the Hammers. We wouldn't have been robbed by a transfer request by centre-back John Scales. He ended up moving to Liverpool. We have some actual transfers here. Philip Albert to Newcastle, one of the biggest ones. Castle went to Chelsea. I don't remember that happening. Dan Petrescu there. Bruce Crapolar went to Southampton. Kobe James, cool name. There's some fixtures here. Season. I've even got the what looks like the predictions. One game on the Sunday. Hang on a minute. On the first weekend of the season, Manchester United are playing at home to QPR to August 20th. And then they're expected to play on the Monday against Nottingham Forest. That's pretty harsh. Wow. And I used to like this bit where it had all the facts and even how the goal went in. Quite impressive, actually, that. Just going back to the previous season as well. Arsenal won the Cup Winners' Cup against Parma. Manchester United won the FA Cup easily against Chelsea. Started at this point. So if we look who's in the lowest league, who's now really doing well, Fulham. Bury don't exist anymore. If we look at Division 1. Oldham must have just been relegated. These five stars are going to win Eltel the 1998 World Cup. Well, for a start, Eltel wasn't manager for the 1998 World Cup. But they've got Andy Cole, possibly Jim Redknapp. Flitcroft, oh yeah, Neil Cox and Neil Ardley. Okay, well, I think Redknapp possibly went to that World Cup in 98, but none of the others did. Can you name me? I began my career at St Andrews and I was once part of the Crazy Gang. I've won one England cap. I now work in North London. I'm going all guns for glory this season. Okay, somebody plays for Arsenal, used to play for Wimbledon. I don't know yet, so let's see who it was. Where are we? Can you name me? Oh, Nigel Winterburn. And of the whole thing. I was so excited when Liverpool were doing well in the league. So we had Wimbledon against Liverpool for a quiz. Here was Derby County's World Cup star, John Hawkes. So, yeah, Liverpool. Robbie Fowler obviously knows his football. And Neil Ardley does as well, and I'm not a fan of. Although he made it, didn't quite get Leicester City's manager. And then a bit, another advent for Boots on the back of the magazine. Okay, well, that concludes the look at that magazine. Thank you for watching.